Guys, welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. You know, I haven't done modern new videos. I'm not playing Pauper, not doing my standard videos because invasion drafts are still going on. Like I said, at some time when I like these flashback drafts, I really like them. I haven't done this since I started Magic Gathering Strat, but last time invasion draft was drafted, I did 12. I like to do like 12 to 15 of a format that I like. And here I am doing yet another invasion draft, and maybe it's not even the last one. So this is really filling slowly. Wow, they start to fill more slowly. I have been sitting here for an hour. But that allowed me to catch up with all the things I hadn't done. So, well, I hope it fills now. It's not sure at 5, it's not even sure at 7. But here we are at 7, so it might now fire. Price list are up. Looking for an awesome first pick. It's Trevor the Renewer. This is a dragon. And I think I'm gonna let this shape my draft. Yeah, I don't think we're passing the dragon. So Treva, and we are now white, blue, green. How different is that? Right, let's see if that works. This effect is really bad compared to the other dragons. But dragons can't be beggars. No, no, that's not a phrase, is it? Okay. I will probably end up being Grixis anyway. But now I'm actively trying not to be Grixis. Crystal spray, what the hell is that? Okay, that was crap. Okay. Ancient spring, recover. Wax, oh, that looks good. Runner offensive, ardent soldier. So it can be a 2/3/4. Stormscape is a tapper. And obsidian has protection. What's the pick here? It's the tapper, right? Passing Soulburn, taking the tapper. Aura mutation. $292. Metatron transport. Repulse. Repulse is pretty sweet. This was a deep pack for my colors. But I'm taking Aura Mutation for value. And for a very high pick sideboard card then. So what do I get? I get blue-green in my last pack here. Well, that is interesting. What about if I had an enchantment that I can destroy? Okay. Mana fixing, they say, exists well in green. Scouting trek, that's not very good, is it? Simon is good. Sulam Jin is probably better. Savage offensive, ardent soldier. I'm not used to this. There's another tapper. Do I take the huge guy? 6/6 even. I think it's the huge guy. Might be wrong. Maybe it was the Stormscape. I don't like the fact that he costs mana. Darga's Attendant, Sparring Golem, Seer's Vision, Fire Screamer, Desperate Research. By a source. Mana spent at activation. That's not bad. Rampant Elephant, Holy Day. Where the hell did my cards go? Jesus. I'm having some sort of problem here. Cremate, Fire Skin, World Council, Rat, Phyrexian Slayer. They're passing me black stuff. Two to fly for four. World Council. Slayer, Fire Screamer. Damn it! Maybe they'll fix my mana too, and I'll be the stupid domain guy. We're just in the 7th pick. Okay, I should probably go for mana fixing at a premium now. Dredge Treefall Healer. This guy's good. Quirin Sentinel, Sulf. It's got to be the Quirin Sentinel then. Wasn't Benelish Dance Rewards of Diversity? Disrupt. Restrain. Some people have used Restrain quite efficiently. But I'm going for the Council. Llanowar Elite. Galena's Knight. Is he better than Prison Barbecue? Yeah, I guess he is. Hardened Soldier is 2-3. That's not very good. Well, I'm taking the Lamb now. Metatron Transport, 1-3 Flyer. That's not very good. And there's the Duskwalker. But I'm taking the Attendant. Obsidian Acolyte. Thank you. Treva's Attendant produces Treva. That would be sweet. But I would be dead to a Grixis deck. So, what fixing did I get? This guy is not a lot of fixing. I don't think that's a card. Don't think Cremate is a card. Don't think Dredge is a card. So let's see what Planeshift brings. What do I want? Planeswalker's Party. Sounds complicated. Whoa! Battle Mage! Thunderscape Battle Mage. The Caldera, wrong colors. Stormscape Familiar for white and black. Walk down, Pygmicave Hull Bridge. What does the Thornscape Atmosphere do? Destroy target artifact. 2 damage to target creature player. But I don't have red, and I don't want to have red. What about the caldera? It's green and black. Stormscape familiar for white and black. Ah! Gainsay, Sunscape Battlemage. That's the draw two cards guy. Yeah, I'm gonna want him. Sunmite Pilgrim. Gerard's Command. Thornscape. Thornscape is pretty good. Mana Silex. But it's the Sunscape Battlemage. Again! Star Compass. Basic land control. Droma's Charm. Counter target spell, target shield. This is pretty sweet. Escape route. Steelleaf Paladin is my card, of course, this time. Because he is really good. Trying not to be black then. Need more fixing badly. Destroy target creature flying and draw two cards. That's not too bad. Not too shabby. Obsidian Acolyte. So we're cutting that and cutting that. And we only have 11 playables. And some of them are really expensive creatures. What would happen if you really play this? This looks very cute. Sawtooth Lion. Thornscape. It's another Steelleaf Paladin. So what's the effect here on the Sawtooth Lion? You draw two cards and puts... Ah, that's pretty good. Let's try the lion and hope to steal the paladin wheels. How likely is that? Warp the Ocean Lashknife Barrier. That was pretty good. There's the Sunscape Familiar. And the Stormscape. I think Sunscape is better. Amphibious Cavu was also very good. Which card is the best here? I'm taking Sunscape Familiar for value. Jailer. Rith Charm. But that's red. Death Bomb. Wow. I'm taking Gerard's Command. There's an Aetherius. Choose a permanent you control. Prevent all. Okay, that looks sweet. There's a Steelleaf Paladin and a Silver Drake. White or blue creature control. I think it's the Drake. I want an Amphibious Cavu. Stone Cavu. Griffin advice. So it's between Stone Cavu and Griffin. Take the flyer. Fits better on the curve. Okay, now I really want the Steelleaf Paladin and not really. But I do want that Amphibious Cavu. I really have no defense. I have a tapper. Pygmy Cavu. Well, I've seen that used. draw a card. I'm gonna get the Pygmy Cavu. And have that in the sideboard. There's a Stone Cavu. There's another Gerard's Command. I'm taking the command. It has to be great. Another Pygmy Cavu. Well, I'm picking that up. But they are in the sideboard. But they will wreck black decks. These are 17 playable, so now we're getting somewhere. We have zero fixing. So you help with black spells as well, yeah. Root. Oh, there's another Steelleaf Paladin. Well, we're doing it. Playing 18 lands, playing the Steelleaf Paladins, hoping we can help them with Sunscape. Stormscape helps it too. Yeah, we're doing it. Yeah, taking the Ingenuity. Just to cycle it, pretty much. What the hell? Okay, now I want to pick up the broken green-blue stuff, like Temporal Springs, things like that. Necrovolver. Okay, this guy will be a 6/6 with life gain. Oh, illuminate. Jesus. Tidal Curia, Jilt, Reef Shaman, Bobcat, Skyfolk. Wow, so many good cards. We are not black so far, but can I really pass up everything in this fancy pack just to take the Skyfolk? That feels wrong. Oh, illuminate. It requires two red. Wow. I'm taking the Skyfall. Damn it! Yeah, $28 card. Come to Papa. And now I have to splash black. So I should have taken the Necrovolver. Or do I? It's not that awesome a card. Okay, it is pretty awesome. It is pretty good. I don't know what's happening with this deck now. 22. Well, still the plan is the Steelleaf Paladin. Guided Passage. Dread Mutation. Wow, this is so sweet. 8 mana. Yeah, I can splash black for Vindicate and Death Mutation. What the heck? Another Death Mutation. No, I'm taking the Temporal Spring here, I think. You could make an argument for the Gorilla and for the Airship. bad it's gonna be the spring. That mutation is so sweet. Green spells, black spells. Yeah, living the dream. This is not going to go well. Or maybe it is. Very different from the Grixis decks. But I think I should just cut black. Especially with this extreme lack of fixing. Wow. Coastal Drake is pretty sweet. Helionaut is pretty sweet. And he could be the one that fixes things. He could. I want a jungle barrier. I really want a jungle barrier. But maybe I have to. I want these guys too. God, I'm taking the jungle barrier. I don't know that was the right thing to do. Necro Sanctuary. Green or white permanent. Target player loses 3 life. That's a lot. Coalition flag is probably not worth it. It is gonna be the slowest deck ever. Dega Sanctuary. You gain 2 life, gain 4 life. Minotaur Tactician. Squeeze and Brace. Lay of the Land could be the fixing I need. Exile Haunted Angel. That's tough. I think I'm going with the Skyfolk, or do we want the Gladenar? Skyfolk. And Gladenar. But this deck is getting ridiculously expensive. Now I have 30 playables. I should probably just cut black. Cut that guy, cut black, come to my senses, cut Vindicate. I don't know. Can I make a 4-color deck here? A blue-green 4-color deck. Splashing white and black. No, no, no. Let's ignore the black. But it's Vindicate. And the 8 mana removal spell, that's probably not good at all. So, I'm playing 17 land and a Lay of the Land, trying to build a blue-green deck that splashes white, that has zero removal. And wins by overwhelming the opponent and playing Gerard's commands. What could possibly go wrong? From your hand into your library and then draw that many cards. Well, I have plenty of two drops. Okay. Playing Treva, the Steelleaf Paladins, the Sawtooth Lion, the Silver Drake, the Galena's Knight, the Jungle Barrier, Temple of Spring, Skyfall, Skyfolk, Solemn Djinn. Glade Gnar. I can't play you, right? Quirron Sentinel, Lay of the Land. Worldly Council. That guy. And the Tapper. That's 20. I feel like Trevor's Attendant should be played. And I'm not gonna have the black mana for this guy. Or am I? Now I splash black and bring in these three cards. Then I have 17 land and a lay of the land. I can get black there in a crisis. I can get a white as well. I have Glade Gnar in my sideboard. And I do have these amazing removal spells. And I will play one source of black mana. Oh, this feels so optimistic. Four white. I'm gonna need white pretty early for the commands. For the... This is gonna be a mess. But if it works, it works. Six forests, and I'm so dependent on getting a forest. Five islands. Am I that dependent on getting an island? Yes, I am. And a swamp. Okay, I think I'm taking this too far. But I am going to play this deck. This is another reason why I should stay in... in Grixis. Naya with black. EPR. Okay, okay, I can't do it. I gotta cut them. What happens then? I get Ingenuity. I get another Plains, I suppose. Yeah. Or is it another forest? So I don't have forests, I only have six forests. So it's another forest. Seventeen lands, and what do I play then? It's a lot weaker, isn't it? No, we are doing it the way we said we would do it. I have a bad feeling about this, but on the other hand, I have sort of the feeling that I have a Vindicate, so this can't go wrong. Let's do it!